Hey everybody, today I've got a Fayo battery pack for reclining furniture. So, you know, I've got this reclining love seat and I've been tripping over the cord for a couple of years now. I said, all right, that's enough. I'm going to go out and buy one of these little batteries and put it on so I don't have to have the cord floating across the floor anymore. And, you know, after a little bit of research, I came up with this and it worked. So, you know, just do a little bit of research. It's not a complicated install at all. This particular one does not come with a transformer for charging, but it can be charged with my existing power pack. So, you know, since I already had that transformer, all I really needed was this battery pack. So there's two wires coming in. One's for charging, and the other one goes out to the recliner motors. They included an extra wire, so if you need to mount it, you know, at a distance from where the motors are, you know, you have this extra little extension. But I didn't really need that. I just mounted it right. There's a little flap on the back, and you'll see that on the recliner, and I just mounted it to that. This one's got a little gauge. It's a two-pin type. There's multiple types of pins, so be sure that you get the right kind of a pin for your particular recliner. This one's got a little window in there that also shows you how much of a charge it has on it. So, you know, the salesman told me when I bought my recliner years ago that this battery pack would last for months. So we'll see. It's been installed a few weeks now, and it seems to work just fine so far. You know, fingers crossed. Little instruction book. Anyway, let's just get this thing installed. Yeah, so you can see there's a little indicator that it's being charged. I want to show that. So I've unplugged the existing. Well, I've turned my recliner up so I can get to the bottom of it easily, and I've unplugged it. That by my left hand there, that's the wires that go down to the two motors, and you see that's the little flap that covers all it up. So to the lower right is the bottom, and that's, you know, all underneath the mechanism. So really I just need to mount this in there somewhere, and I'm looking for a spot that there won't be a bind on the wires. And you got to remember that the recliner moves, so the cords need to be able to move to fully extended and back and not pinch or get caught in there. So, you know, I think that spot would have worked all right, but I chose to put it up on top of the board where it's resting now, so that once the recliner is turned back on its upright, it'll be easier to read the power gauge and then charge it. So I actually moved it up on top of that board. So it's in there, just two screws in this case. And I would say, on those two screws, put a washer under the screw, because in this kind of a deal, I mean, that looked like plastic, easily broken. But you can see the wires are still loose, and really that's it. So thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe. You know, I'm trying to get up to that 1,000 subscriber mark. Take care, everybody, and I hope you find this video of value.